Hello. I do appear to be alive today. To a degree. With a certain intention, perhaps. Tan hello, Burn and hello, Revolver. I see that you found your way in here as well. As I probably will fumble around for a bit trying to get this to look right. Choose the correct thing to use for this, which I'm pretty sure this is just the 4x3, which is not actually lined up with the way that I have the chat box set up right now. But if I switch to this one, I'll look at him. I actually bothered to put a picture over there at that time, because this will be the inaugural use of that space as something other than just a space with a background that isn't just nothing, but that is just a... Well, it is basically nothing. If I take this away, it just looks like that. Which is how I've been using it for the longest time, but now I guess this guy will be there. Just kind of hanging out, and that probably will not be the only capacity in which he makes that appearance, though. As we're gonna find out in just a moment. I have the category set to just chatting, because I thought that maybe I was gonna do the whole thing that I do sometimes at the beginning, but honestly, since this continues to be an hour at which is technically quite a bit past the point where I would ideally project to start these streams, I guess I'm gonna go ahead and actually just play the game today as I have been, and hopefully, maybe, just maybe be able to correct that and just, well, in, I don't know, in just watch, but at some point during this week, maybe, possibly, perhaps, maybe not in a very clean fashion, but at least get started on that. But those corrections are ever ongoing, because I can never seem to make them stick. Also appear to have gotten some kind of thing in my Steam inventory. I'm guessing I got a second trading card from that game when I was testing it just a little while ago, just to make sure that everything worked. Yep, I got my second Vary card after I got that exact same trading card as a drop that I played about 2 hours of this game in 2015. But now I suppose it's time to see what else I can get out of it. But let's see, I'm gonna go ahead and fade this out real quick. Slow as I am to do so for a track with this particular source. Because right now I think... Oh well, hold on. Probably should have done that a moment earlier. Actually, is this thing even visible right now? I don't believe it is now. I'll do this instead, I suppose. I will turn this on, and then I will click this one more time, and then I'll do this while the screen is happening and see if that does anything. There it goes. Alright then. Alan Wake, which may or may not be a game that I vaguely recall hearing for the first time many years ago in an Ashens video with no context whatsoever. I didn't really think about too much at the time, but several years after that, managed to get for dirt cheap just before it was temporarily delisted from the Steam store, because apparently they were just gonna have to delist it because there was some licensed music in these games that was going to have its license expire, but then it eventually came back. At least I managed to get it for dirt cheap. The original version, apparently the remastered version, exists now, even though I don't believe that I've seen it, at least not in the places that I've looked in. And I see that it still has the continue game option, which tells me that maybe it still has my save from all those years ago, but given that I don't remember anything, probably gonna be a good idea to just start from the beginning, would wager. I've already had a look at the options. I'm pretty sure the only thing that I changed is the screen setting just a little bit, and just make sure that the subtitles are on, which certainly they should be. Mastery set, but PC is exclusive to Epic Games Store. Well, there you go. Would explain why it's, at least at this point, beyond my reach. Okay, I would assume that, at least for the purposes of this, I can clearly pretend that it's 10+ years ago. And so I am experiencing this along with the rest of the world with no outside influence whatsoever to my perception of this game. Or the first time. I have no idea what the difficulty would imply in this case. I guess I'm just gonna go ahead and autopilot this. I'm good with normal.
Stephen King once wrote that nightmares exist outside of logic, and there's little fun to be had in explanations. They're antithetical to the poetry of fear. In a horror story, the victim keeps asking why, but there can be no explanation, and there shouldn't be one. The unanswered mystery is what stays with us the longest, and it's what we'll remember in the end. My name is Alan Wake. I'm a writer.
All right. I mean, I suppose there is one.
I've always had a vivid imagination.
Well, I guess we're gonna have to wait for this first.
Settled me. It was wild and dark and weird, even by my standards.
I talk too slow to keep up with this.
So yes, it began with a dream. Following a typical nightmare pattern, I was late, desperately trying to reach my destination, a lighthouse. For some urgent reason, I couldn't remember. I'd been driving too fast down a coastal road to get there. I'd seen the hitchhiker too late.
I then had to reenact that one mission from the Wii version of Trauma Center. First one.
Dead. I was convinced they'd put me in jail and I would never see Alice again. Suddenly, his body was gone.
But you can still hear the horns from the car in the distance. Actually, I don't even know if the car horns somehow were light up. Like, if they somehow were not loud enough to trigger the microphone by themselves, but I'll look up to the light. Yes, we can't actually move right now. Is it going to slow down now? No. They appear to be in the correct configuration right now, so I will be very happy to keep them as such. And I think a little too much may have happened. It's really, sounds like he's just carrying a bunch of copies of his own stuff in the back of his car. I wonder if there's a reason for this at this point. But yeah.
I was certain I had just driven from this direction, but now the road was blocked.
Oh yeah.
The lighthouse. I knew there was something important waiting for me there.
You know, I saw this brick wall very plainly, and yet even until he pointed it out, it didn't hit me that that probably shouldn't have happened, or that probably shouldn't be in place, given that we literally just drove through here. I also see that we have the left bumper slash L1, because I'm actually playing this with that PlayStation controller. That's the run button, much like in Deadly Premonition, I believe. Unless that was R1 and I've got it backwards, but I don't know. Different games seems to have a completely different range of buttons, even if you use a controller with like standard quote-unquote layout to do the run. Also, if we do keep getting this ongoing commentary, which I assume... Okay, apparently not in this one particular occasion came back. If I go up to the bridge, he'll probably come back. Get this ongoing commentary, I get the feeling that the pacing of the things that are said.
The bridge had collapsed. I'd have to find another way to the lighthouse.
Are I gonna be a little too, they're gonna be moving a little too quickly for me to focus on certain other things, unless he just happens to go quiet right after that. Someone's missing. That's not my face, is it? I can't get a very good look at myself. Looks vaguely like myself. How can I be missing if I was never here? What lies beyond this point?
You don't even re- recognize me, do you, Ryder?
Why do I get the feeling that... Hold on, I guess we have to...
Just make up stuff.
Literally pace away from this... This man's... Ow. I'm saying that I suck if I am your work and a result of your stories, but apparently I don't suck enough that I'm not gonna be able to kill you. But I was gonna make some kind of comment about how this seems oddly very aesthetically similar in many different ways to the beginning of Deadly Premonition, which came out the same year. But I don't think that game had the first bad guy, I guess, going on a little spiel about how apparently this might be an In the Mouth of Madness type story. There's also a picture of a guy with a diver's helmet, I think, and a QR code, which I could scan. I guess I can at least try it. I might as well try to humor this. Where is my phone? Here it is. Also, hey, Agar. Until this is one of those times in which I am having a very, very easy time enunciating. Right. I believe I should have at least a thing that should let me do this. The fuck? Well, I don't want to write a review for this app right now, I just want to, you know, maybe see if this thing will be pick-upable. Okay, here we go. Okay, apparently it's a QR code for facebook.com/AlanWake. A place I don't believe I will be going to at this time. It's certainly not on my phone. At least. I have an iPhone, your regular camera can do it. Actually, most phones should just have it in your regular camera. I have an Android from like a couple years back, I think. I don't know if it has like a default option for that. But... Well, the app that I have for that seems to have done a job. Right, I guess I have to dodge. I'd like wait for this guy to come up to me on purpose. Sometimes highlighted with a cinematic moment.
Hitchhiker was a character from the story I've been working on.
Well, maybe not every single time it's gonna have that time effect that we saw both of them just now.
How does it feel to die by the hands of your own creation?
Alright, I guess this is not the time to stop and smell the roses after all. I can look behind myself, but and it looks fine, clearly. Technically. The distortion effect closing in on me should be cause for concern, because it doesn't seem to be quite as violent as the giant vortex that emerged from it may have suggested. At least it's being, if there is something there, which apparently it is, it's moving kind of slowly though. Nice enough to. Let me get all the way across the bridge before it messes with the bridge. Try to play Stuart, my best friend, whom I totally remember.
It's coming inside now.
But if we can just wreck the bridge, we're really gonna be fine in here.
No!
Help apparently McLean ever learned how to do the dodge move.
I was trapped. There was no way out.
Well, there were a few ways out. I just wasn't willing to entertain them. Well, I can see where Reaper got his inspiration. Tom DePaulo is apparently linked to this diver's helmet, man.
The cabin was a death trap. I had to get out.
I could go into the Tom DePaulo door or try to. Don't rightly see anything I can do beyond random jump though. Oh, okay. I guess that door just eventually actually opens up for me.
You are hurt. You should go into the light. You are only safe there.
Right bit from the movie Tron. But higher resolution this time. Okay, apparently I get healed by lights.
Well, but I have something important to tell you. It goes like this. For he did not know that beyond the lake he called home lies a deeper, darker ocean green, where waves are both wilder and more serene. To its ports I've been. To its ports I've been. Do you understand?
No.
I understand the words. Which has the power not only to heal, but to turn back time as well.
The darkness is dangerous. It's sleeping now. When it feels you coming, it will wake up. There's no time. I can only show you the most important thing. The hitchhiker has been taken over by the dark presence.
Oh, and there he is.
Now, the darkness protects him from all harm. Only light can drive the darkness away and make him vulnerable again. Here, take the light.
I could take the light, but I guess I better pick up some revolver ammo first. Right.
Only light can drive the darkness away. Turn your flashlight toward him and burn the darkness away.
Even that I didn't have the option to make any of the other Kingdom Hearts starting artifacts.
You did it. Now the darkness no longer protects him, but it's still inside, controlling him. He can't be saved. He's still a threat. He is still your enemy. Here, take the gun.
Right, I'll take the heavenly light and heavenly gun. Oh wait. I mean, given that I can, it doesn't really look, oh shit, that I can. Okay, no, I guess the flashlight when I'm not, when I'm not focusing it is my aiming sight.
That is all. I will give you back your dream now.
Alright, thanks, light.
Terrible darkness was taking over the world. The lighthouse was the last safe place on Earth.
Light blinds the enemies and burns the darkness away faster, but also.
You made me this way, and now I'm gonna kill you.
It also. Oh, there he goes. Oh, wait, there he comes. If I could. There we go, actually aim at you. I would probably be, doing state of affairs. I have for 3 bullets if I load in 3 right now. Wait, what? Still says for 3. So I didn't actually get into my supply, or was it 33? Or does it only count down once I fire? I haven't been paying attention, I guess I will do that. I was gonna make some kind of joke about how this is apparently something that has similar game mechanics to the. Oh, sure. To the Action 52 game Illuminator, but the moment for that has passed. You know it counts down when you fire, right? I saw that that time. Could insert a battery to do this faster, but why would I do that when I can juke and jive and avoid any and all harm this way? And assume that there's not gonna be like more of those hitchhiker copies popping out of the ground like in Deadly Premonition. Very good ammo. What's that thing that keeps moving to the yellow keyboard prompt just have now right next to me? Nudge it by accident periodically. Right. Well, I guess we have the flare gun. I guess we must have gotten it from that box itself. If we're gonna be using light as a weapon, I guess that means that flare gun is also going to be an actual gun that we shoot at people instead of how it actually would be used. Could use the flare gun, but it also just flex on my limitless last light source that I have. Oh, not to worry, I have the best dodging moves possible to just save as much time. Okay, I think all of these guys are unprotected now, so have to go full North America and then. Can't believe I actually got hit once. At least I can dodge while I'm reloading, that actually seems pretty generous. But I'm glad that that's the case. Say something about dog breeds, but I feel like that might be too much of an in-joke at this point. What does it mean that even when you become pure darkness, that just makes you even more immune to the... Right. So thank you for throwing those cars ahead of where I am, so I can not have well warning of where I'm supposed to not step. I appreciate that kind of sportsmanship. Oh, here I am. See this thermos on the right? Apparently we can't pick up a copy thermos. I would like to imagine that there's probably some kind of reason for that, but that is, I don't know at the moment. If the game intends for me to find out, then let it.
Just another nightmare. Everything's fine. You dozed off.
Right. Anything more than dozed off would be news for everyone.
Cheer up, handsome. We're here.
You're in the community labeled Bright Falls, which is right in front of us. Woke up just at the foot of the tower in the dream. Where we would have had to go up to the final boss of Paper Mario 1. And apparently we're picking up right here.
Let's act like we're on vacation. Go stand next to that old gentleman there. I want a shot of you with the town in the background.
Sure. I'll even give you a title for the shot. A city boy, moments before he got eaten by a bear.
Or I could go this way. Also, hello, Tree Penguin. How you doing? And hello to Chocolate Cake, if I didn't already say that. I mean, before another several minutes happen and this fairy thing gets where it's supposed to.
Hello there. You picked a good time to visit our town. Deerfest is just 2 weeks away.
Deerfest, huh? Did you hear that, honey?
You have a lovely wife. If you don't mind me saying, I'm Pat Main, by the way. Nice to meet you.
Yeah, I see.
I won't pretend I don't recognize a famous writer such as yourself, Mr. Wake. A pleasure. I'm an avid reader myself. I hope this isn't too presumptuous of me, but I'm the night host at the local radio station. Any chance I could get an interview?
Look, Mr. Main, I'm on vacation. In fact, I'd appreciate it if we could keep my being here just between the two of us. I'm sure you understand.
Fair enough. You can trust me to be discreet. Not a hard man to track down if you change your mind, though. I hope you two have a lovely holiday.
I don't know, I'm a little concerned about how the geometry of that cliff over there keeps changing periodically. This place might have something a little funny about it. I'm sure it'll be fine, though.
I got a couple of really good ones. And I see you made a friend. That's cute.
Right. Yeah?
Hey, bestseller! Who's my favorite writer? Are you there yet?
Barry. Yeah. We just got him.
The local's giving you trouble? Just say the word and I'll hop on a plane and come make sure that you're left alone, Al.
No, Barry, we're fine.
Great. Great. Just want to make sure you can relax and recharge. So, where's the place? Has it gotten your creative juices flowing?
Barry, we're just settling in.
Okay, Al. I'll call back later to make sure you're doing okay. And you call me if there's a problem, okay? Okay. Just looking out for you, buddy. Talk to you later.
I love you too, Barry.
You know he's going to be calling you every 5 minutes.
Barry is Barry. I can always turn off the phone.
What did I tell you?
Text message from Barry. He says hi to you too.
Alan, we're here. Come on, let's get back to the car.
Well, clearly the strangest thing about that scene was how apparently the sound effect for a text message being received is two measures. Alright. Should get back to the car.
You get the full service here. I've made all the arrangements. I drive the car. I'll even carry the bags. All you have to do is drag your cute butt into the car and enjoy the ride.
Yeah, sounds like you've got a lazy bastard for a husband.
So I have to go on this side.
Yeah, but I got a thing for him. Come on, you lazy bastard.
But I'm also guessing that that this line was a thing before the certain other line from whatchamacallit, hey guy. I like being distracted, but that did remind me of a certain other line from Resident Evil Revelations 1. I'm pretty sure that was like a few years after this. The car is the red one. I thought that the car that I was driving in the previous scene looked more like this, but I guess this must be it. Right.
We need to stop at the local diner to get the cabin key from the landlord, a Mr. Carl Stuckey. He's waiting for us. I'll go fill her up while you get the key. I'll pick you up here in, say, 15 minutes?
Sure.
Alan, thank you for coming here with me.
I love you too. Go on. I'll promise to behave. I'd forgotten there were still places like this. Towns where everybody knew everybody.
Welcome to the Odeer Diner.
Hi, I was wondering if you could help me. I'm looking for...
Mr. Wake. Alan Wake. Oh, God! I am your biggest fan. I know people say that all the time, but I really am.
I'm glad to hear that.
Rose.
Rose, I'm looking for Mr. Stuckey. Carl Stuckey?
Carl? Of course, Mr. Wake. He must have gone to visit the restroom. He'll be back in a moment.
I can't believe it. I've got all of your books.
Don't come in here, those.
When they took it out of the window.
And you keep it here. Well, okay. Good for you.
Oh boy.
Try the coffee. Just don't blame me when you fall in love, because it'll break your heart when you have to leave.
Rusty here is no longer human. Nothing but black coffee under a thin layer of skin.
Yeah, that makes two of us.
Well, I can't help but notice a similarity with a certain other Pacific Northwest aesthetic. Well, a few more really, but one particular one. It doesn't really seem to be a conversation, depending on how you define that, but just examine this.
Or is your wife with you?
So much for clarification.
I get off work at 6.
Thanks, Rose. We'll be sure to keep that in mind.
Right, why not fucking meet the old gods here? Well, this is technically a point in the game where I believe I probably got to. There's one particular scene that I remember vaguely as like the part where I stopped when I played this several years ago, but it would probably be a good idea if I can keep like the stuff that's coming up slash backseating to a minimum. I mean, I know that sometimes the way that I do things might lead to someone who knows a lot about the game, wink wink. A certain level of suffering.
There's a tune right now. Coconut number 6 in the jukebox. I'd do it myself, but both of my legs have gone to sleep. Bad circulation. Yeah.
Are you serious? Coconut again? You disgust me. Call yourself a rocker. Unbelievable. Ha!
But I mean, I've definitely been in that position where I watch someone play something or react to something that I...
Just because we're brothers, don't think I won't murder you in your sleep.
But look, that's where I'm good at video games, if I'm really over here.
That's my favorite tune! Coconut!
Shut your mouth, you demented has-been!
Don't go in there, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark.
I think I can handle it, ma'am.
I wonder what they call her. Couldn't possibly be Lantern Lady or anything like that. Alright, I guess I'll pop the jukebox first.
It does that! Get stuck! Yeah, you need to give it a good solid whack.
It did seem to do something, but all right. I guess these event icons still exist.
What I'm talking about, yes.
This is it. I've died and gone to hell.
I am listening carefully, but this seems a little bit quiet. I guess I'll turn it up on my end. It was a little bit... And I feel like several years ago, like even before I played this for the first time, I had seen some kind of meme related to this track. Which I am not particularly familiar with myself.
I didn't want to wait. I wanted to find Stucky. To get the key and get out as soon as possible. The waitress was giving me a headache. Overeager fans always did.
I'm sorry, Ellen. Your thoughts just kind of interrupted whatever she was saying. Well, it doesn't seem like I get any kind of a prompt to interrupt the doors other than just walking into them. it for this one.
Hello? Mr. Stuckey?
Carl couldn't make it. Unfortunately, he was taken ill. But I have the key for you and instructions on how to get to the lake.
Okay.
I wish you a good stay in my cabin. I'll come by later to check how you've settled in. And to meet your wife. I insist.
Thanks.
Okay. Well, no. Cutting just seemed to give her these, very avoidant.
Very inspiring.
Very, mysterious cinematic angles, but then she's just here as a normal character when we get back to the actual gameplay.
You got lucky this time, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark. This really ought to be fixed, and then I must remind Sarah to change the lights at the station. It's been too long already.
Well, I can definitely see where it's a another kind of joke about Inspiration and Insidious, but Insidious does seem to be yet another thing that came out the same year as this. That these characters having their own voice lines rather than try hard enough for the copyright robot guts to be appeased.
Mission accomplished. The key and the directions.
My hero. I got some flashlights, just in case.
Hey, wait! Mrs. Wake! Your keys!
Oh, how convenient.
That diner was a real nut house.
Can you believe this place? This would make a wonderful setting for a book.
We're supposed to be on vacation, Alice. I'll figure it out when we get back home. Okay?
Okay. We can talk about this later.
Batman here. I'm PBFF.
I didn't want to talk about it. I wanted to bury my head in sand.
Here's another one of my favorites to go.
Once upon a time, I was a successful writer, but that was a long time ago. I hadn't been able to write a word in 2 years, not since my last book.
And now the weather. It's gonna be a clear night, so you folks in the big city might want to look up every once in a while and see those stars winking down at you. It gets pretty dark out here, but they'll light your way.
That's what the actual rock island looks like that the house is on.
It's something, all right. Don't worry, honey. I'll get you inside safe and sound before it gets dark. And I've got the flashlight.
I know. I'm okay.
Alice had a phobia. The fear of darkness. I wanted to make sure we were inside with the lights on before sunset.
That's kind of poignant, but let's make some kind of comment about this, or we could just turn back and go the other way. So we'll try momentarily.
It's nothing like in the brochure. It said near the lake, not on it.
Yeah, you get the feeling that we might have gotten japed there.
This is so much better. It's wonderful. Our own private island.
Yeah, the private island, which makes it look like the house from The House on the Borderland by William Hope Hudson. But instead of just being over an abyss with like a waterfall or something, it's just on top of water. Like those houses that apparently people built in Minecraft after the Enderman came out. What if I go this way though? What if I want to take a hike and get a better view of what all the animals in the mountain will see when they look down at our house? Apparently it's no problem. Well, I guess this is our car right now. Also, I found a coffee thermos. I still don't know what the deal is with these, but I guess whenever I see one, I will continue to be compelled to snatch it. But no, apparently the gates that are here, even though they don't look like they're padlocked or anything, will not yield to our presence. Is the collectible? Yeah, I kinda figured. At the end of this, I will probably know what they're for. It's a little easy to see, like, parts of the background changing geometry of this engine. It's not like a big deal or anything, but, you know. Alright, on to Diver's Isle. Let us not comment on the crows, of which there seem to be a whole lot. Maybe once the crows leave Diver's Isle, the Diverish Empire will crumble. Or the bird-like cabin. And a Twin Peaks reference? Well, I thought if anything the Twin Peaks coffee reference would happen right there in the diner, but Alan here doesn't seem to be as eager to try the coffee as a certain other character, which I alluded to there. And I'm pretty sure that that scene didn't even happen at the diner in Twin Peaks anyway, it happened at the restaurant in the hotel. But I'm pretty sure that it got perpetuated by more stuff that happened in the diner anyway.
The island had once been the site for a love story. Maybe it would be that again.
GB or GB? I'm guessing GB. Okay.
Alice had told me about Cauldron Lake Lodge. The old building used to be a hotel, but these days it was no longer open to the public.
Well, speaking of Twin Peaks, I don't know if I see a waterfall anywhere around here, but a building that apparently used to be a hotel, or so he says, perched on the edge of a forested cliff near a river or a lake like that. Does seem like a pretty straightforward aesthetic reference. Well, the whole fact that coffee is a collectible is a reference. I mean, I guess you can look at it that way too. Maybe if they had made it cans of Georgia coffee, like in a certain commercial, then there wouldn't have been any doubt left whatsoever. Now let's see if we can either get in here or find a different way to go around, because I did see the lower parts, but well, let's just take a look inside. Wait, no. I'm not supposed to be using the mouse. Okay, I guess you're just gonna keep giving me the mouse prompt even though I'm using the controller. I could just put the mouse like somewhere else so this doesn't ostensibly keep happening. I'm gonna do this. Wow. That was the mouse sensitivity, by the way. I don't think I could have just played this with the mouse without adjusting that.
Can you figure out how to get the power on, honey?
I suppose that's a non-factor at this point. Alright. Well, I've got my own light. I could create another light by lighting a fire in the fireplace. I could examine this box.
Filled with books by Thomas Zane sat on the shelf. I've never heard of him before.
Hello? Me neither.
Anyone here?
I see that we got Snow Hills on the shelf, though. I wonder if that's by Snowy Hills. And that seems to be the only book, well, except for Believe in Change, which sounds like it would be the... Yeah, well, based on that cover and that title, I'm guessing it would be some kind of self-help thing. But apparently all the other books were too blurry to read. Well, I'm sure that if there's a way to turn on the power, it would definitely be upstairs, because it makes sense. That is definitely where such things are located.
For the moment, the oppressive feel of the nightmare I had seen on the ferry returned.
Also got a bit of an Insidious style flashback of that same character. And also a vague sense of reminiscence about the first Resident Evil game as well. Alright, so... Captain Cutler guy, who may or may not be Tom the Poet. Gonna keep showing up. That's a very blurry crawl, too. I mean, I'm guessing that's crawl. July 1970. I get the feeling that it's not July 1970 anymore. Have a more stilted view of the environs from the windows of this cabin. I don't believe I found anything there, though. Can I open these doors back here? Nope. Hey, Alice. So let me tell you about all that I found. Oh yeah, so it does. Well, it could be a telegraph cable for when someone wants to send us a telegram from the shed. They don't have to leave the comfort of this structure.
An old generator had been connected to the power cable.
There was nothing behind the green drums in the corner. And I guess the generator was also conveniently already stocked with fuel.
I'll freshen up a bit and start settling in.
I'm sure we won't have any problems finding any more of that around here. Oh, this is me looking around a bit.
It was a beautiful place. I told myself I could rest here, sleep here, and forget about my work. I thought we could be happy here.
I think anywhere that you can sleep well is probably a good place to forget about work. And if it isn't, then there's a problem there, I would say. Alright, that was my look around. Just kind of a wistfully out over the lake one more time. And jump excitedly so that I can open the door.
Honey?
Well, I guess we're not concerned about the fact that we can't open the doors down there.
Well, hello there.
I'm not the surprise. It's my study. Go take a look.
I mean, this is a study?
Okay.
Surprise!
Oh boy.
What is this?
I guess I have a small confession to make. I thought maybe you could write here that a change of scenery would get you past...
Damn, Alice, you... Everyone
Hey, just hear me out. There's a local doctor, Dr. Hartman. I read a book of his. He has a private clinic here. He specializes in helping artists.
Maybe so now you want to get me committed?
No, it's not like that. That's not... Alan?
I don't, just don't. I don't want to hear it. God damn it, Alice. God damn it. I knew she would hit me in the dark. I needed some time alone to think things through.
Didn't see any jump scare faces in the dark. I had no reason for any kind of concern, even though this is ostensibly after I experienced that nightmare myself.
Damn it. Alice? Dark. All the lights were out.
Well, I guess we're back to action mode, and now we could go with the
Alice,
the cabin bonding. So I can see where the bat swarms from where the wild got their inspiration. Oh, ouch! That was very rude, sneaking up behind me.
No.
Don't feel a moment.
Keep going.
Wake up.
Alice?
Waking up in the crashed car felt like I had woken from one nightmare and entered another. I couldn't remember how I got there. All I knew was that something terrible had happened to Alice. The phone was dead. I'd have to find help on foot.
Well, that's what happens when you go for a swim, or you just try to like take a dip in a body of water and you forget that, either forget that you have your phone in your pocket or you underestimate how the tide is going to work.
Among Alice's things was a book, The Creator's Dilemma, by a Dr. Emil Hartmann. Seeing the book brought back my fight with Alice. I didn't like it, and I didn't like the guy's smug face on the cover either.
I was a little weirded out by how the guy looked a bit like, some relative of Kevin Bacon, but we're not gonna talk about that right now. You're just gonna make your way over there.
My best bet. They'd have a phone I could use. It looked like a long hike through the forest to get there.
Well, if there wasn't a straightforward way to just get down there from here, which I suppose there wasn't after all, never mind. I guess it did probably take a while to get there.
Damn.
I'm pretty good started. Well, guess now I won't have to look at that guy's smug face again. Every cloud has a silver lining, as they say. Don't know what looked weirder to me, the guy's face in that book's cover, or the way that they model the characters' faces in the King's Quest VI fan sequel called The Silver Lining.
Hello?
Oh, might be some candy down there. It looks perfectly safe. This also looks, not suspect at all after what that, last nightmare sequence gave us.
Someone there? The loose sheets of paper were pages from a manuscript entitled Departure. That was the name I planned to use for the next novel I had never gotten started.
That doesn't say anything about the novel itself.
I couldn't remember writing it. In the scene on the page, the hero was attacked by an axe murderer in the woods at night.
Okay, well. Attacked by a shadowy murderer, or the title page of the manuscript. Thanks, Alan. I could have made that up by myself. What about this one, though?
The man turned to face me. His face was covered in shadows. It was hard to make him out in the darkness of the forest that surrounded us. But the axe he lifted was plain to see. It glistened with the blood of his victim. He grinned madly. The shadows were alive, distorting his features. It was a scene from a nightmare. But I was awake.
Well, that sounds familiar. Find this page in nightmare difficulty mode. Okay. Well, I guess we're not gonna get all the pages now. Unless I replay this at some point. But right now, we better just try to reach the gas station. Could try off-roading as much as possible here, but I don't want this to turn into, for example, that one time that I tried to play that other game. Apparently, people know what it is. Probably blanking the title right now. Ethan Carter? Yeah, that's it. Vanishing of Ethan Carter. And instead of actually doing anything in the game, I just ended up exploring every inch of the starting area for 2 hours.
The lights up ahead were a good sign. Maybe I wouldn't have to hike all the way down to the gas station to find a phone.
Yeah, there you go. I mean, the fact that some of the path seems like an actual dirt path is probably a good sign. And that this fence got wrecked and has not been addressed is probably not a good sign, though. As far as environmental visitors must visit the site of this. What is it? Bottom. Biltmore Logging Company. And employees must wear protective eyewear at all times. Alan didn't wear protective eyewear, and now he's got blood trickling down his temple. If he had only worn his goggles, I'm sure he would have been fine after whatever happened to his car. I'm thinking we're not getting in there through. Maybe it's time to play a tightrope with this tree. I think it's a bit dumb to need to play through the game again to get all the collectibles for the sex trade just to have some real juicy plot stuff. Well, I might look into that depending on how I'm feeling once I get through most of the regular parts of this.
Hey! Hey, you!
Phil!
There's been an accident! I need help!
Deposit!
Listen, I need to...
Premium cabins for rent in...
Nightfall!
Oh, hell.
Carl Stuckey.
Pleased
to meet you.
Non-refundable reservation
deposit required. Fair and square.
Well, that doesn't seem fair and square is how it just runs away after doing his little sales speech there. I guess he must be angry that he didn't take his merchandise after all. Help, hold on, Carl, I need to...
Taken stood before me. It was impossible to focus on it, as if it stood in a blind spot caused by a brain tumor and eye disease. It was bleeding shadows like ink underwater, like a cloud of blood from a shark bite. I was terrified. I squeezed the flashlight like my life depended on it, willing it to stop coming any closer. Suddenly something gave, and the light seemed to shine brighter.
Well, that might be a callback and a call forward simultaneously. Well, then Black Knight, we're enjoying the game. I see you need to play it multiple times regardless. Oh, there you go. I suppose that pretty much vindicates my decision to play on the middle difficulty for now. Okay, so these things are still physics objects even now. I'll have to write down to run them some more. Apparently I can't push them any further in that. Or maybe I can. Okay, just needs a little bit of a encouragement. So if I approach it from this direction, I don't know if I'm gonna be able to make it move anymore. I thought maybe I can get one of them to roll all the way down there and roll off the cliff. Well, maybe not this time. There you go, enjoy the rest of the game. Alright, see you, Revolver. Oh boy, here it comes. But yeah, I'm probably gonna be playing this game all week. This might be a very bad position for this. Successfully japed. But I just pop in here. That'd be fine.
I had to figure a way out of this. Any second now, and Stuckey would be knocking on the door with his axe like Nicholson in The Shining.
Yeah, because the reference wasn't clear enough before you said it out loud. Thank you, Alan. Remember, beyond the lake, your home lies a deeper, darker ocean green. We'll try to keep that in mind as well. Alright, let's pick up some Energizer batteries. We do feel a hankering for those.
I was about to open the door, as long as I was liable to catch an axe with my forehead.
Those batteries that keep going right now.
Trying.
Nordic walking.
It's the latest
thing.
incontestably
proven health benefits let you
kill two boxes
with one
stone.
You can see the sights.
Yes.
And keep those cholesterol levels.
Hello?
Yes.
Hello?
Oh. Well, that's inconvenient.
This is bad.
It's alright, well. Doesn't seem like we can get out this way. At least it wasn't possible a moment ago. Things seem to have changed a little bit, so... Okay, well, speaking of references or similar moments, what makes him kind of joke about, he always put it, Vampire the Masquerade Bloodlines, but that's a game that I know for a fact came out before this, so there you go. Don't appear to be in beachfront area this time, or at least not a sandy one.
Suffered the same fate, but I wasn't planning on staying to find out.
I mean, I don't know what I hope about Stucky at this point, given that he also seemed to be trying to pierce Johnny. Wait, there were? Oh yeah, here they come. They were very stealthy until I actually caught them in my line of sight. Wait, hold on. Mr. Okay, you know, open the door as well. Which I did not realize was a physics object. Give me just 1 second. Ow. That was rude. Right, mister. I hope... Oh, okay. Oh yeah, something else that I forgot about is that you don't actually need to,
My head bound, concussion.
You don't need to do, like, the powered up version of the flashlight to be able to dispel the darkness, I guess.
Bodies. They just disappeared. If I was dreaming, it felt real enough to make me sick.
Could turn on the portable battery, but what if we get our bearings on the situation here first? Oh. Yeah, okay, hold on. I'm getting punched in the face repeatedly by the electricity on this pole, I guess. I'll need a moment to also recover from that. And also a kick that I wonder which of these two options would be more appealing to me personally. Maybe we should check out the directions that are apparently revealed by this paint, which is completely invisible. Unless you shine a little bit of flashlight.
Revealed by my flashlight, someone had hidden a chest of supplies near it.
What kind of supplies? The flare gun. Okay, I guess we get it for real now. I'll be using the flare gun right now, though. Yeah, it's gonna be some special graffiti if it's completely invisible. It doesn't have that kind of light source shining directly at it. And let's start messing with this stuff. I guess it's just the light. So maybe we could have used that during the fight, but I guess that moment has passed. Let's kick this thing instead. I can definitely see what that accomplished.
The dark forest was the last place I
wanted. Oh, well, now again.
But I had no choice. I had to get to the gas station.
Okay, so we want to power on one thing and power off another. Oh shit. Actually gonna freaking throw axes at me like the apparently we need to get another one back. Like the enemies in House of the Dead or something. Well, if he doesn't have Wolverine claws or anything like that. Maybe it's not quite to that level, but still. What do we got? This does seem like an emergency, so geez, we got more batteries and more ammo. I am a little bit curious as to what would happen if I were to be faced with one of those guys and I didn't have any ammo left. But... No. I mean, for the scene back there, it seemed as if there was... like, killing those two guys that jumped out at me was a requirement based on the dialogue that came after, but I don't know anymore. What's on this manuscript page, though? Those daydreams about Wake, which is all the way down here, apparently, in contrast with the orderly appearance of all the other pages so far.
Rose knew she had been gushing, but right now, she didn't care. As far as she was concerned, her brief meeting with Alan Wake was literally the high point of her life. She watched as he got in the car with his wife. She was pretty, confident, at ease with Wake. Not like Rose. They were pretty much. She'd have given anything to be called their friend.
Well, she could have not presented herself in that way, maybe. I don't know. There's definitely a stigma with fans of things, I would say, and honestly, as someone who's seen that for a very long time, it feels like that stigma is at least partly justified. Also a fat person in the lake, and also that insidious veil woman again. Hey, bird. You're not vulnerable to my flashlight power, are you? No, but apparently it will be trackable if I use my flashlight power, but will immediately disappear the moment I stop using it. I wonder if there's any significance to that. Goodness.
When I saw the river below, something uncoiled itself inside my head. I realized that I'd have to find a way across. I didn't even want to look at the water.
I mean, doesn't seem like it's that difficult to just go across the river. Or at least this part of it, by going across the tree there. Perhaps he meant in, like, the rest of it, because that's literally not the extent of the flow. Like, come over here, yeah, why don't you know it? I kind of suspected that there might be something like this over here. The coffee thermos is mine now. If we keep going in this direction, and get a little bit of the river crashing into this through the rocks, I don't know if that's supposed to be by design or just a consequence of the geometry, but... Oh, well, here comes another man. That's how I scream when I want to.
In the dark, stalking me.
Maybe he should have renamed himself from Stucky to Stalky, if you will. I'm sure nobody's ever made that joke before. Also, we got a new manuscript page. What do we got? Barry's Arrival, which apparently takes place after the previous one. Oh, this are all from this episode only. I guess that makes more sense.
Barry Wheeler was bouncing off the walls. He jumped on a plane after his calls were ignored by both Al and Alice for several days. It could mean that they were both on a second honeymoon. But Barry didn't buy it. Al had been way too unstable for that. Not sleeping. Messed up. Barry had years of experience dealing with Alan Wake, and he couldn't ignore it. Something was wrong.
Well, I guess we have to just take its word for that. Ignore its word for that at the moment, since I have no idea what the relation between Barry and Alan Wake would be at this time. But I guess we have to go after Stocky after all. Stalker man. Lithium batteries. I don't remember the other batteries that we've collected were labeled as such, but... I do feel compelled to hoard as many of these batteries and just resources as possible. Well, there's gonna come a point where that just doesn't make sense anymore. Like, if you're gonna be hit with a kind of hard, you know, carry limit, like in... Oh shit. That kind of hit me a little too quickly for me to react. Like in the game I was playing yesterday is what I was trying to say, but I, you know how terrible I am at actually staying focused on what I'm doing. I'm trying to stay efficient like this, where each enemy takes 3 shots to kill after you shine off their shield. So hopefully it'll continue to be a viable way to proceed from here on out. Okay, so... doesn't seem to be anywhere else I can go, so I'm guessing now it's finally the time for Alan to show up his incredible climbing and jumping skills. Going area ahead. Proceed at your own risk, even though areas like this should be probably regulated, or at least, you know, have it clearly marked where people are working. We could go that way, or we could notice this shiny graffiti this way. I suppose go up here. Not only am I following the arrows this time, but also these dots. Dots which probably lead this way now. Taken are filled with darkness. Well, they don't seem to have come from a Liam Neeson movie, which is a very obvious joke to make, but... maybe they are a bit more related with that other thing that was also called Taken that I vaguely remember having seen advertisements for. Back in the day, but never really watched or looked into myself, which was apparently something to do with alien abductions. At this point, I wouldn't be. At this point, I have no idea what to expect, I'll put it that way, but the possibilities are certainly wide enough that I wouldn't be surprised if aliens are involved in this somehow. We have a bit of a very jocular Silent Hill nod. Okay, here we go. Is there anything else in this direction, or was... okay, no, I guess this direction was just for finding that small cache of supplies. I'm guessing we can't climb onto and over the bulldozer there, or whatever that is, to get on top of those log piles and skip having to go all the way around like this. We do seem to have like a hidden stamina meter, I guess.
The staircase was broken. I had to make my way up some other way.
Yeah, there do seem to be a lot of broken stairways and platforms in this spooky backcountry. It does seem a little bit Mutoki. I can only carry 42 revolver arrows. What about the other thing, though? 15 batteries, okay. They also at the limit, so I can carry up to 20 batteries, so... I guess now is the time to climb up there. Start using things without trying to be too conservative about them.
There was no power. There was bound to be a generator somewhere at the logging site.
Maybe we can follow the cables, even though those cables don't seem like they're power cables there. Are there other cables that would be connected to this box that we can follow at all? I don't think I'm seeing any. This box just seems to have been stuck here onto the tree with nothing attached to it. Well, better just look around and find something different then. Can't climb onto these logs here.
With all this forestry equipment around, there had to be something you could use to reach the top.
I mean, you could try climbing onto one of these things. That might be a good idea. Like, maybe move it close to the stairs and then what's left of the stairs. Then climb on top of the vehicle and use that as a boost to be able to get all the way up, but maybe not. Or rather, maybe that's not something that's going to occur to Alan here at all. I mean, I guess he doesn't necessarily know how to operate them. Or if those things even have fuel inside, but, I mean, in a situation like this, it probably wouldn't hurt to try. You're killing things by shooting them after shining your light on them, like in Illuminator, like I said. Also, play the remake of Illuminator from Action 52 Owens. It's actually unironically good. Even if it does get pretty difficult later on. I don't even know if there's an end to that game, or if you just... you just die after a certain point because it's too hard, but... well, here comes somebody. two people, as a matter of fact. Oh, ow. Didn't even see that guy's axe projectile, but... Okay, now's the time, I guess, to continue to use this. Oh, gosh, hold on. Something that I didn't... I just tried to use B to, well, not B, circle, really, to dodge. Instead of the actual dodge button. I don't know why I did that, but... It seemed to make sense to me at that particular moment. But I'm guessing because these guys were guarding this thing, this is what we're meant to find. Which clearly means that we need to take a look back here. Honestly, probably shouldn't be messing around so much with the background since I feel like this game is giving me a bit of motion sickness, but... That's my instinct of adventure. I can't leave any paths unexplored, not if I can help it. Oh, we should be able to pick up some of the extra supplies that were left in this thing. Alright, I can jump for joy now that I've topped myself up yet again. Are we really gonna make a bridge with the logs? I guess that's what we're doing. We're gonna assume the logs are gonna be stable enough that they're actually going to, you know, be able to support our weight for that purpose. I guess we are forced to. Have it here. Oh, we can jump across, no problem. But the question is, are we going to be able to jump across from the logs, which are at a lower point right now, to the next platform over? Apparently so. Apparently that's not going to be an issue. So the top of this bunch of logs is also lower than the other one. Only I had a melee attack, it would knock these cans over. I mean, surely you can, I don't know, pistol whip people with your flashlight or something, Alan. Or just use your literal pistol for that. Checkpoint reached. I think that we stepped under that thing already, though. I think the checkpoint was reached when we stepped onto, like, this part of the land, but... Is there anything in here? This looks like the exact same kind of model thingy that we found one of the pages in a while ago, but this time we got more flare gun stuffs. Which I think also becomes automatically equipped when we pick one of those up. Which doesn't seem like the most convenient thing. I would go in that cabin back there, and I guess we will. It's not like a very big thing. Shotgun ammo.
Well, I was just outside for a breath of fresh air, and what a night. I know most of your... Take a moment. Step outside for a spell and breathe in. The weather is absolutely still. The sky is crystal clear. It's like the forest is quietly breathing along with you. You listeners know I'm a night owl, and it's on nights like this I wish I wasn't cooped up in the studio. Makes an old man like me wish I could just roam wild. But here I am, and who'd keep you company all night long if I weren't? It looks like I'm not the only one staying up late. Caller, you're on the air.
Hey, Pat, it's Maurice Horton.
Hello, Maurice. What are you up to?
Well, I was just taking Toby on his walk.
Oh, isn't it beautiful out there? Probably a rabbit.
Sure. Toby loves rabbits.
Well, sure.
Anyway, I figured that, you know, if anyone runs into Toby, they could grab him. My number. numbers on his collar.
And Toby's a friendly dog?
Oh, Toby loves people. Usually he comes back, but we were pretty far from home, and it sounds like he went pretty wild there. Great dog, but he's just too dumb for his own good.
Well, Maurice, it's out there now. Hope Toby comes home soon.
Yeah, thanks, Pat.
You have a good night now.
Oh, shit. Make sure that the... And the things don't... The wires that are connected to this thing, which I probably can just disconnect at this point, I'll just take them. Just... End up getting tangled and bringing everything down that's nearby. Well, I can only imagine that Toby would have been a reference to the tracking dog Toby from the Sherlock Holmes novel, The Sound of the Four, from like the 1880s. Or 1890s, I don't remember. Like, finds pages.
At first I kept finding the pages as if by accident. The book I couldn't remember was either a terrible and true prophecy, or an act of creation that had ruined the world. I began to hunt the pages, feverishly, for they held the answer to the mystery. With it, I could save myself. With it, I could save Alice.
Alright. I guess we assume that the pages are important, even though... There wasn't really any reason for me to ignore them before, but now they're touting themselves to be a bit more than would have been evident at first.
The gas station was closer now, its light welcoming in the darkness.
Paul makes the best dogs in the state. Barry Forster is the best with no coat. Monster Dog is second best. The famous dog is...
Then why is it called the famous dog, if it's not even the best one? Or are these completely subjective declarations that shouldn't be formulated so salaciously? I don't know, but we do seem to be getting more motion blur here. I feel like maybe the motion blur is part of the reason why I'm getting a bit of motion sickness from this. It doesn't seem to be as bad as other instances of motion sickness I've got in video games, but... Honestly, yeah, the aiming for the gun at least seems to be very generous. Where it lets you aim and still hit the enemy in the right place. Alright. Okay, I guess if this guys I gotta keep... Oh shit. I keep showing up and apparently showing up in groups with the ones that are closest to you and not being the ones highlighted. Oh. Apparently they can outrun you if you try to run away from there like this. Well, I'm trying to run or dodge, but I guess it didn't work that time. I didn't pick up the shotgun ammo yet at this timeline, though, apparently. Or turned on the radio. We'll turn it on, but I'm not gonna, you know, stay around for the whole spiel there a second time. I'm guessing that we also didn't grab what's in this thing yet either. Flare gun. It does switch to the flare gun automatically when we pick that up. Well, instead of running away, I guess I do have to gun down each one of those things. We already read the page, and we don't want to jump over the page, we want to actually pick it up. We'll pick up this thermos.
It's light welcoming in the darkness.
Yes, we can't use the thermos of coffee to heal ourselves, though. Make it over here and find this thing and revolver ammo. So we probably try to start this. I can see where Dead by Daylight got its inspiration. Now we have too many batteries, but and we have too much ammo to pick up more of that. But well, where are the rest of these guys? Safe haven. Or are they just gonna disappear into nothingness now that they've activated the lights? I better just keep on running along the edge, since that seems to be where the good stuff is. Because that'll help me not die. I see you guys, or at least I heard them before. Wasn't really an issue trying to keep track of everywhere. Oh, and there's more of them. And by more of them, I mean one more of them, which I tried to dodge, but apparently it wasn't successful that one time. Ow. You're still... You got the dark shit on you, don't you? Yeah. Alright. So better top off with the ammo that was left back here. And now just try to keep moving forward. I guess I am gonna have to keep on fighting those guys if more of them show up though. Running away from them is not going to be too effective, as we've learned before. But maybe this time I'll be able to... Yes, I know. I heard that guy coming up. Damn it. Oh, whatever. I guess we'll do this after all. Moment from that exciting exchange to see what's in this page.
I stepped into the gas station's garage. It was dark and quiet. The place was a mess. It looked like someone trashed the place or that there'd been some kind of fight. Light spilled into the room through an open door at the back, and I made my way toward it. Without any warning, I was blinded by a bright light. An old portable TV on the shelf had come alive by itself. Impossibly, I could see myself on the screen, talking like a madman.
I guess I don't have to be a flash forward, because I don't think we've seen anything like that yet. Errors in the game. Oh, I guess we probably should just click select again. Not back, not share, or anything like that. That button will forever be called select, as far as I'm concerned. There you go. After that grueling, resource draining part of the world. Could go that way, and I guess probably should go that way. But... These rocks seem like they're very light for how they're moving that way. Come on, roll down the hill. I can maybe ride on the rock myself. I wonder if this game has like some interesting glitches that would be associated with the physics of like that test. Okay, more resources found. And by more resources, I mean another flare gun thing, which I'm still neglecting to really make use of. And okay, that thing's over there, so now we... The fact that we're gonna be chased by that thing, it just doesn't seem safe. Well, like, something like that is gonna happen, but we can easily get out of the way by just going off-road here. I guess it also makes sense that that didn't end up happening. Not like that chase that you get at the end of the first part of Resident Evil 4. I mean, shall we fight them? I guess we better fight them, you know, just like in Resident Evil 4. It feels like at this part maybe you're supposed to run away instead, but... Like, you can easily take care of all these guys, even if they seem like it bad. This guy doesn't even look like he's armed. I don't know if he was. But now we can just pop him dead instead. Let's grab this first. This thing to the left also seems like it's glowing, but apparently it's just a trigger light. It says hazardous environment something. It's way too bright if you actually shine the light at it, so you have to try to read it this way, which doesn't really Matters hazardous. Environment. All visitors must visit site office. Yeah, it's the same kind of sign that we found before. There's nothing in the corner there, much to my chagrin. We're back here. Well, I have a shotgun now. So if it's gonna be that much of a... I guess we can try it at least. It's probably not gonna be stingy with ammo based on what I've seen so far, as certain other games that could be described as survival horror. Let's try the television first. It'll be me babbling like a madman, maybe. Or it could be a Twilight Zone ripoff.
Einstein, Sagan, princes among men. But the price for such a legacy is steep indeed. In Night Springs.
It's literally the Twilight Zone font too, alright.
Quantum suicide. If our lives are already written, it would take a courageous man to change the script. Having called a press conference, Dr. Barclay Colvin is about to demonstrate that very courage.
Ladies and gentlemen of the press, I am Dr. Barclay Colvin, and I'm glad so many of you could join me here at the Moorcock Institute. Tonight, I'm going to give a practical demonstration of the many worlds interpretation. As you can see, this is a loaded 9mm pistol. It shall be part of a thought experiment. And now, a real experiment, known as a quantum suicide.
Did he say suicide? Is that a real gun? He's kidding, right?
Please, please, stay calm. There is no risk. Observe what occurs when I place the weapon against my own forehead. Now, you might think this round is merely a dud. Not so. Observe the flower pot. And yet, I myself cannot be harmed with this gun. With each pull of the trigger, two new realities branch off. One in which the weapon didn't fire, and one where it did. With my machine here, I have ensured that this reality is always the former. I have bestowed upon myself quantum immortality. Under no circumstances can this gun kill me.
So wait. What you're saying is that every time you pull the trigger, in another reality, you die?
Yes, of course, but that's completely trivial. There's an infinite number of things that could happen at any moment, and they always do happen somewhere. The point is, this one thing did not happen here.
You're insane, Colvin.
Insane? Insane?
Hey, was this thing supposed to be plugged in? I stumbled on it.
You fools! Gaze upon quantum immortality. Poor, poor Dr. Colvin. Filled by his own hubris or the ignorance of the masses. Perhaps he should have left the crate unopened, the decaying atom unobserved. Curiosity often kills the cat. In Night Springs.
Okay. Well, that wasn't quite what the page suggested it might be, but... It also occurs to me that I don't think I've ever actually read anything by Michael Moorcock, even though that's one of the names that apparently keeps popping up. And these types of stories, I have read lots of stuff by people who came a little bit before them. Okay, I don't know what that did. Seems to have maybe switched something off. Just the fact that we got like the giant ongoing darkness fog tells me that there's probably gonna be more fighting in this area. Well, these lights are being read out. It does make me kind of wish that there existed another version, perhaps in the quantum infinity of realities, as coming to my head all of a sudden for no particular reason. Perhaps there is a reality in which that guy's lines and shouting and distortion were recorded by Gilbert Gottfried instead. Would want to know what that would sound like. Oh, there he is. What? Oh, okay. I don't know who even shot me there. Oh, there's another guy back next to me that I can't really see before. Apparently I can just one-shot these. Oh fuck, these guys with the shoot gun, but I also can get very easily melee to death by that guy. I don't need anything more room here, do I? Well, I'll just wait until after this confrontation to check back. I'll stay on this side this time. What if I aim for this guy first? It seems like he's just staying up there. But he's invincible to that, so I'm just wasting my... No, I think he is like slowly getting weakened, but... he weakens a lot slower than the rest of these guys. Wow. Okay, I just got an achievement for killing two dudes with one shot. It would seem. I mean, that guy didn't die to a single shotgun shot. Or even two. Or even three. There we go. I guess that was a boss fight of some kind.
Leaving behind only a lifetime of nightmares to come. Assuming I'd reach the lights at the gas station alive.
Well, we can't do that, but I guess we better get our resources back after that battery encounter. Let's pick out some of these lithium batteries. Okay, apparently just one thing of batteries is enough to carry more of that. Let's get like infinite revolver ammo. I guess you have to, we don't get infinite batteries from here though, do we? We only get a couple. Well, you do get like infinite charge on the flashlight if you wait. Guess I'll switch over to the revolver again, though. Seems like that's gotta be the more efficient thing to stick to, and I should save the shotgun ammo for special occasions such as those, maybe. It's my coffee thermos now. I'm guessing that just would not work at all until that guy was dead. Killed Stucky, the guy who was supposed to have given me the key to the place that I was gonna stay in originally as I came here. So it would appear. And there it is, gasoline, after all that roundabout.
I had seen in Bright Falls when I first arrived with Alice.
We're finally here at the place with the parade float of the deer with peeled off skin in the front. Oh, I better just waste some time getting into this place.
Just experienced in the darkness, the lights of the gas station felt comforting, at least for a moment. The sane world reasserted itself.
Well, if you stay for a moment, I'm just thinking that that's going to last more than a moment. Checkpoint reached. I still haven't gotten to the point where I parse each light source that looks like that as a potential checkpoint or safe spot. What do we got now, though? Apparently we're missing a page, at least one page, from the ones that aren't nightmare only. It lies to the sheriff and Stucky taken. I think I also completely forgot to read about at least one that I found before. Oh, let's sweep both of these ones now.
Been on Cauldron Lake? She asked. The sheriff looked at me suspiciously.
The early morning light flooded through the office windows. I would probably never have gotten out of the woods alive without her help. But I couldn't tell her the truth of what I'd faced the previous night. She'd think I was lying or crazy. She'd lock me up, and she wouldn't help me find Alice.
Okay, so whoever she is in this situation, it's not Alice. Maybe she is the sheriff, but I have no idea. I don't think we've met the sheriff yet.
And tried to shake the cobwebs from his head. Ever since the couple never showed to pick up the keys, things had been fuzzy. Something, a feeling, caught his attention. Stuckey looked up and stared as his brain tried in vain to process the horror before him. He stumbled back, knocking over a can of oil. A black pool spread across the floor while he struggled for a brief moment, then let go as the unrelenting darkness engulfed him.
Well, maybe if Alan Wake and his wife had taken those keys, he would have been spared of that. 68th Annual Deerfest. Maybe the one the following year will be a bit nicer.
The Deer Fest had been 2 weeks away when we arrived. If the day count on the banner was right, I was missing a whole week between the night we got here and now.
Missing a whole week? I don't know how I was supposed to process that, but maybe we got here when there were 2 weeks remaining, or like right as it happened. On letter 299, letter plus 309, so on letter 319. I don't know where the decimal points are supposed to be there. I would like to assume that they at least are supposed to be there and keep going that way, but I'm guessing that that's probably not a good idea. Now we can totally silent heal this. The fog is totally safe, or maybe not. Or we can clearly run farther into the fog to avoid that confrontation. I think we can probably just avoid the confrontation altogether just by continuing to go ship to move and trying to dodge, which I tried to do there. And yet it's not to work. No, never mind, we just got double shanked. Double teamed with those. Let's try that one more time. Let's pick up the page. Let's if there's anything that we really picked up here. I guess I can read the dialogue here one more time.
2 weeks away when we arrived.
Okay, yeah, I missed that one part of the dialogue.
I was missing a whole week between the night we got here and now.
Yeah, I know, we get it, Alan. Now we can please move it a bit faster.
To find a phone to call for help.
We could find a phone to call for help, or we could go find the thermostats over there. The apparently dead-end tunnel that we can find. And the thermostats over here. Okay, so we're definitely going to be ambushed in just a moment here. What if we walk backwards so that we can't be ambushed from that direction at least? Oh, no, never mind, that doesn't change anything. At least this time we get the drop on those guys, so to speak. Not too much so, but a little bit so. And I know they're armed. Oh shit. Oh shit. Now surely we can do the rest of this in peace. Still should do it at a brisk pace though. Oh no, we're getting attacked again really, so we're going to attack a bit like different spawns of enemies as we come on, let me please at least have the hooligans in one direction away from me so that I can get both of them without having to turn around. Apparently being smart enough that they were trying a pincer attack, but at least they managed to survive. Question is, now can I survive long enough to make it low, for fuck's sake? Or they just keep coming? Make it back long enough that I can, get under that light and get my health back. That would be nice. There we go. Well, apparently I'm out of stamina, so I can just keep running even the same way. Ow. How dare you. And now they just run away, okay. What am I focusing on now? And I'm gonna be focusing on the deer first thing again, am I? Nope, okay. But it is gonna... Oh, this is what I meant is... I'm not gonna be getting the dialogue again, but... I can focus on that again, but at least it doesn't force me to... walk around at a snail's pace while I listen to the dialogue again. What if I tempt fate some more by going this way this time? I mean, hopefully you get some kind of additional checkpoint by going to the light again. got the pace, Alan. Try, you know, that Swedish walking that that guy on the radio was talking about, I think. Or maybe not him, maybe like that. Maybe Stucky himself. Kept extolling the virtues of exercise while he was talking to you. He's a swell guy like that. Well, predictably enough, I guess we're gonna be stalkied again, but... Oh shit, why did we aim down at the ground? Something that I did consciously, I can tell you that much. Oh, another one. Another couple of these fuckers coming in immediately. I'll do that. Doesn't seem to have actually been anything over here, so I guess on this occasion I actually did just do all that for nothing. Oh, unfortunate. Yeah, I know. I was expecting it. I'll try to run away. I assume that if I make it far enough here, they will stop chasing me. The other ones did. I don't use up any more bullets on these guys. And they seem to just be going down the road that way. Now, I guess this also counts as a safe haven if this is a separate light source. Okay, now we can actually move on, I would hope.
The garage was a mess. It looked like someone had trashed the place, or that there'd been some kind of fight.
Or maybe this is just how they have their garage in these parts.
Now I could smell her perfume in the room. I'll reach her, I'll fix it up. I'll bring her back. The story will come true. If I stop, she's lost.
I don't believe this.
It's been me on the TV, talking crazy. Was I losing my mind?
I don't know, but I guess that was the thing that was supposed to be predicted by that other page. Not the one that was the Twilight Zone, but with an even lower budget kind of thing. I mean, I don't actually know if Twilight Zone, the original, would have been like something that would have been considered low budget for the time. Should probably look into that. Big stuffer. Seems like these are pulling no punches as to what they are nutritionally. September 15th to 18th. That's when a certain country's independence day happens. Games and activities, raffle tickets, fishing competition, pie contest and surprise competitions, live music for the children, walk to the Charlie afternoons, and Montgomery the Mystic's amazing Phantasmagoria in the evenings. That means the legendary Deerfest Parade. Well, if that Phantasmagoria isn't like the this Sierra game Phantasmagoria, which I was able to confirm does work in ScumVM with the CD rips that I made from the version that I was able to buy. And I'm not interested. Nightfall's Hunting Club, fireworks galore. It is guaranteed. We guarantee you will get service, I guess. Doesn't seem like a very old claim, but get some Wiper Pro, some anti-rust, some... Can't even read what's on that. And some cheese and cream. I could go for some cheese and cream right now. Maybe not, because I do keep getting the fucking motion sickness, but... maybe in a while I won't care about that anymore.
Oh, thank God, Sheriff.
Sheriff Sarah Breaker, you are...
I'm Alan Wake, but listen! I was in a car crash. My wife, Alice, she's missing.
Calm down, Mr. Wake.
We were staying in a cabin on the island, on Cauldron Lake.
There's no island on Cauldron Lake, not since the big eruption in the 70s.
Please, I can take you there, okay?
You look like you've taken a pretty bad knock to the head. Are you okay?
Listen.
We'll figure this out. Please get in the car. We'll swing by the lake, and then we'll go to the station, okay? Mr. Wake, have you seen Stucky, the guy who owns this place?
I realized I couldn't tell her what had happened in the forest. She wouldn't have believed me. And then she wouldn't have helped me with Alice.
Clown, they call the Sandman. Chocolates. I wonder if that Sandman is gonna do something. Something like summon the old gods of copyright, in which case it will not be alright. Okay, there we go. I'm gonna have to cut that off. Taken. I think this might be the place where I stopped, yeah. I think I remember this flashback, so several years ago when I actually tried this game briefly, this is the part where I stopped, right after this cutscene or sequence, I think. Well, everything past this point should be completely new to me.
Honey, I'm home.
Back here, sweetie. How was it?
Worst weather I've ever seen.
You should put some coffee on. It'll warm you up.
Honey, how rich are we that we're able to afford a place like this in New York City? Are we Stephen King rich? Is that not just like a joke analogy?
Coffee's on.
Great, thanks. I'll need it if I'm gonna finish this by tomorrow.
Or are we more like J.K. Rowling rich? Well, let's step on the couch for a bit. We've just come in from, like, this kind of weather. I'm sure that won't leave any kind of bad consequence. I feel like we would have to be J.K. Rowling rich to be able to afford a place like this in this city, but I don't know. What's that book? That one that seemed like the Human Island. One of the few books in this shelf that... Oh, there's Snow Hills. There's the stack of books that starts with Snow Hills on one side and has... Nothing changed, but leave it changed at the other. And there it is again, right shelf that's next to that one. I see another one up there, but let's see. Mom's Survival Guide. One end, and... And I can't quite read the one at the other end. Yeah, I don't know. It's actually too blurry. I should probably also not be doing that because, you know, my brain.
Oh, hey.
Oh, there she is.
Those cover mock-ups? They're on your desk. Tell me what you think.
I didn't think you'd get them done this quickly.
On occasion, I can perform all sorts of miracles, my dear.
Where are they on the desk? Okay, so they're in the other room after all. Well, before we go there, we will actually go into this room and grab the coffee. It'll be the best mug collector in the world by the time that this is finished. It's a manuscript page one. Where? Here? Oh, it's on the left. Makes sense. Sudden stop one and sudden stop two. I don't know when we grabbed one of those, but... Apparently there's quite a few of these pages on this episode compared to the previous one.
It's true what they say about the fall and the sudden stop at the end. I'd lain here in the snow while the lurid chain of scenes that had led me here kept playing in my head. A rerun of my own private snuff movie. A memory of my corpse. Alone at my own wake.
Wink.
Femme Fatale was gone. Only a sour taste remained of the kiss that killed me.
The kiss that killed me.
This was a late goodbye. 13 years after I'd gotten my revenge, it finally caught up with me. It had been a long time to bear the pain. My blood painted the snow red, a gruesome slushy, dissolved all the scattered painkillers and leisurely dripped down to the sewer, mingling with the bile of the city, becoming one with it. I can see them now, my wife and my baby. Honey, I'm home.
Snow and the sewer? So they're in a city where it snows. I wouldn't know anything about that. Here's that thing, here's this. Why don't we examine this first? Alan Wake returned to sender, what I can't forget. Alex Casey, the things that want, and the fall of Casey. So I guess that must be his potentially self-insert character in these stories, like with Blake Backlash in a certain other video game series.
These look really good.
Oh, sure, until Barry gets his hands on them. Which, by the way, will happen over my dead body. The last time was the last time. Oh, and speaking of Barry, he called. Alan! Alan!
Well, somebody should I see another big, another QR code back there. That one does seem different. I don't know if I can... I guess I'm gonna try to scan that one too. Because I don't think I can zoom in on that anymore. Let's see. Please stand by for a moment while I try to scan this other QR code with my phone. Oh well, will that work? Okay, well, helped. There's that freaking thing. That car horn that's just gonna randomly appear in the nighttime every single time that I do this, except this time it happened at 10:33 p.m. Also, apparently that code gives you back this text. Turns out this isn't too bad, even if you're not sitting on a couch when you play it, who knew, Will. Well, there's several things about the circumstances in which I am playing this that contradict that statement. One of them being the motion sickness, but the other being the fact that I'm literally on a sofa chair right now, and I didn't even have to get up to. Yes, I know, I get it. Can you please shut up now? Can you, well, can you? I already said that. The fact that I didn't even have to get up to scan that. I guess a sofa chair isn't quite the same as a couch, though, but... I mean, functionally speaking, I would say that it's not that different.
I'm right here, baby.
I'm fine, just get the lights back on. Please.
Honey, it's a power outage. I've got the flashlight.
Hi, okay.
You okay?
Hi, okay.
Sorry. I just...
He's gonna shine this light in your face. I'm sure this will comfort you greatly.
We'll just break out the candles.
I know it's stupid, but it's just... Especially when I'm not prepared for it, you know?
That's a lot of candles. That's a fire hazard right there.
Tell me a story, Ryder.
Okay. I used to have these nightmares when I was a kid. The dark really spooked me, too. When it got really bad, my mom gave me this old light switch. She called it the clicker.
The clicker, huh?
Yeah. If I ever got scared of the dark, I could just flip the switch and a magic light would scare the monsters away.
Oh, sure.
Here it is.
Alan.
Maybe it'll help you, too.
Yeah, nice story, writer boy. You made that up right now, didn't you?
No, no. Seriously.
I love you, even if you are a liar. Thanks for this.
Well, you know what they say. Or what was said by a very recent Mexican writer. Liars are the best storytellers. Well, in a way, whatever you believe, it says more about you than me, and that's the key to telling any story.
How do you feel, Mr. Wick? Any nausea, disorientation, anything like that?
I've got some nausea.
How are you feeling?
I'm okay. My head's fine. I had to lie about my headache and memory loss. He'd send me to a hospital for tests. I couldn't leave without Alice.
Very well. I don't think you have a concussion, but you've obviously been through quite a shock. You should take it easy for a couple of days.
Thanks.
Well then, Mr. Wake, we're done here. If the pain gets any worse or you experience any other symptoms, you should come see me. I'll let you get on with it then. Sarah, Sheriff Breaker, is waiting for you. She's very good at her job. I'm sure she can locate your wife in no time.
Doc Nelson was the image of a small-town doctor. Sheriff Breaker had called him to the station to take a look at the cut in my head.
Well, I guess I weren't able to determine what made that cut. Can I drug with something here? Not for a moment like I could, but it's this. Oh, big fish.
I'm sorry you had to cut your morning fishing short for this, Doc.
Oh, she's a beauty, ain't she? Not the biggest I ever caught, if you can believe that coming from an old fisherman like me, but she's right up there. Now, she's a largemouth bass, which is what you're after if you prefer a lure. Now, if you want either trout or salmon, on the other hand, then it's fly fishing for you. You a fishing man, Mr. Wake? Oh, doesn't really matter, I suppose. But it can be very relaxing out there. You can't get... closest thing to heaven.
I'll take your word for it, Doc.
Time for me to go. See you tomorrow, hopefully. When I can speak again. Thank you. But yeah. I suppose see you later, Chokokiki. Yeah, hopefully I can figure things out so that I don't have... So I don't end up streaming like a couple hours after I was intending to start streaming for the next few streams that I do. And thank you for stopping by as always, and also
thank you for testing the lights, Miss Weaver.
I guess I can ostensibly try to keep going until I finish one more chapter, but I don't think I'm gonna be able to even do that. I'm gonna try to do something to avoid the motion sickness thing, and also hydrate a little bit more. I don't know if that would necessarily help me with that right now, but I will do it regardless. I guess I should probably stick to water for this. Being that I don't really have any more water, that's within my reach at least. I have to get up to get some right now. Richard Ball, Bruce Dansky, and Jacob Medler. On a camping trip, overdue, haven't been in contact. If you have seen them or know their whereabouts, please know, please call this number. Also, this man, he has a knack for winning contests. I wonder if that's supposed to be a meta thing that I am, of course, completely ignorant of. Win your contest and have your picture put in the game or something. Well, that's probably a bit more likely to get noticed than the crease hole in the room. Sarah Breaker is there. Apparently also press R1 and hear this clicking sound, but it doesn't really result in anything.
Mr. Wake, the sheriff is waiting for you in her office down the corridor. That was Cynthia Weaver. I guess you can call her the town eccentric. She used to be the editor of the local newspaper, but she's focused on, other things these days.
No.
Fit right in where I come from.
As you can see, she's a little obsessed with maintaining the light bulbs of the whole town, refuses to step on shadows, things like that. Back in her day, she wrote about all sorts of weird things in the paper. Bright Falls has a colorful history. Of course, what small town hasn't?
Alice was missing. I needed help to find her. I wasn't ready to leave.
I wasn't ready to leave, but I was ready to at least bump the doors open a little bit, so I guess I probably missed the conversation. Probably missed the conversation, excuse you, with, or at least witnessing a conversation with a different character here, but... And probably, oh hey, here's a manuscript page. Probably guess what it was about. What's this?
Mulligan here. Looks like someone really thrashed the garage. Over.
Okay,
Roger that, guys. Keep looking for Stucky. Jane's out.
Well, I guess this means that Alan isn't a suspect for the garage being thrashed, even though. Now, when the police showed up because he called him there, he would have been the only one there. I guess the fact that he called him there probably gives him some credibility. Okay, we could pick up the cell phone, or we could do something else in the office, maybe.
Your phone, Mr. Wake?
Alright, fine. I mean, is there anything else that we could actually... No, I guess not.
Have you started looking for my wife yet?
My men are already on it. Now, can you tell me what happened?
I'm not sure. I can't remember. We were arguing. I walked out of the cabin.
The cabin on Cauldron Lake? How did you end up at Stephanie's gas station?
I wanted to tell her what had happened last night, but I couldn't. She'd lock me up. Excuse me. I need to take this. Hello?
Alan, please help me.
Alice?
Stop talking to the law. You'll do exactly what I say if you ever want to see your wife again.
Who is this?
Okay.
There's a hole in the fence on the left. Look inside the junker. I left a little something there to convince you we're all on the same page here. After you ditch the cops, you're gonna meet me in Elderwood National Park. There's a spot called Lover's Peak. Midnight. Don't do nothing stupid, pal. We're watching you.
Mr. Wade, can I help you with anything?
I need to get some air. The sheriff said I could go out back.
Of course, Mr. Wake. You can get there through the cell corridor. Just don't mind Walter in there. He's one of our regulars.
Hold on a moment. Let me try something if I go to the advanced graphics options. Is there an option for... There is no option for motion blur, even though I think that might be one of the things that causing... like giving me this crazy motion sickness that I'm getting even in this... scenes that don't have a lot of movement.
The deputies, they don't understand. They won't listen to me. I need it to be bright in here.
Well, it's not gonna be bright, apparently. It's gonna be very blurry, which is very, very unfortunate. Well, I guess the blur is, like, if it wasn't present in some scenes, it would not look the way it was supposed to at all. But, well, before we go meet up with the Mafia. Let's see these pages that we picked up. I guess that we must have picked up the one that we don't have selected right now first, so let's start with that.
Alice looked through the viewfinder, lining up the shot. Cauldron Lake was breathtaking. Something caught her eye. A figure standing in the shadows behind the cabin, like a thin woman in a black dress. She lowered the camera and looked again. No one there. Just a collection of bushes that looked vaguely human-shaped. She shook her head. And laughed.
Black dress, but also didn't really remark on the veil, which I would have thought would be a more standout thing.
In spite of its human mask, to describe the dark presence as intelligent would have implied human qualities on something decidedly inhuman. Nonetheless, it found the one spot in the diner that was dark enough. Some light spilled into the corridor, ravaging it. But it took the pain. Horrible as it was, the writer would soon fix that. He would be coming to the one place where it still had power.
All right.
The early morning light hurt my eyes and made my head ache. The man on the phone had said, go through the fence on the left.
Well, watch through the fence on the right. Apparently it's in Nitro Girl. It also goes straight ahead to find a couple of collectibles, or at least a collectible, and presumably an optional thing to listen to.
Well, folks, it's been another long night, and it's about time for me to sign off for a while. God knows I need my beauty sleep. Just one more item before I go. It's been a busy night for the sheriff's department. We've had a few broken windows, even a report of shots fired on Main Street. Deputies Mulligan and Thornton had to deal with two intoxicated young men who were celebrating the completion of their Deer Fest float. Now, folks, we get this every year. I know it's exciting that the big day is almost here, but let's save it for the party and leave the gunplay for the shooting competition, huh? There's no point in getting all wet yet.
Don't better run away from the potentially licensed music now.
Find a hole in the fence behind the police station. There was something for me in an abandoned car.
Charford Town employees. Well, we could go check it out now. And there it is. All this fence is like, this goes to a completely barren area. Or not barren, but like overgrown and abandoned area, I guess. Just push this thing or kick it. Because we need to destroy it utterly. Can't just gently try to move it out of the way so that it still exists somewhat when we're done with this place. The caller meant business. It's not very clear what the fuck the caller was up to, though. Well, it's before we acknowledge that, let's get another page.
The kidnapper fired his gun one last time, and the shadow vanished into the darkness it had come from. See? Nothing to it, Wake. The thought of Alice in his hands was revolting. We stood on the wooden platform of Lover's Peak, the waterfall on the mountain behind us, the lights of the radio mast blinking red in the heights above. I fought with the urge to take a swing, force myself to speak. Let's cut the act now. Where's my wife?
Well, let's pick that up from over here on the opposite side.
Barry?
Ow! Ow! Thank God! Where the hell have you been? I've been trying to reach you for a week, you and Alice. Oh, I've been worried sick. I flew out yesterday. I'm here in Bright Falls.
Barry, listen to me. I'm at the sheriff's station. Come and get me. I can't talk now.
Ow! What the hell is going on?
I had to get the sheriff to let me go. I needed to get to Elderwood National Park to meet Alice's kidnappers.
Well, I mean, was the sheriff trying to hold you here? Sure, there wasn't gonna be anybody stopping you from just walking out the front door except yourself just a moment ago. Well, this guy is... Oh, shit.
There is a light that reveals the world of his story from darkness, shapes it from nothingness. The way a sculptor carves a statue from a block of granite. If I stop, the world I'm making dies. Darkness will reclaim it. It's a long, hard journey into the dark. Alice's life is at stake, but I can't think about that, or I'll lose it. The dread lingers at the edge of perception. I'll push on. Anything is possible here. I'll write the story. I'll save her.
Well, I can see where Dark Souls got its inspiration. It comes from the dark, and to the dark it will return, but also... If that happens with writing, doesn't that mean that this is also indirectly inspired by a never-ending story? There's so many references in this that... Well, so the TV is right, I guess, and I guess this guy's dead? Or we're just sleeping? Doesn't seem to be dead. I think I hear him snoring. Oh, we can switch the lights on. I didn't even realize that we had that option, but... Maybe we should have done that before.
Brothers might have inadvertently caused on their recent and regrettable little outing. They are not accountable for their actions, of course. I can assure you that my staff has been reprimanded.
Tor and Odin never caused any trouble to anyone when they were still living at their farm.
Indeed. All we can do is to slow down the progress of their dementia.
Also, time to fade out into another cutscene.
I'd like to leave. Am I free to go?
Well, we still need to talk about...
Am I under arrest?
No, of course not. But I need to know where you'll be staying so I can get in touch with you.
I'd avoid the motel. The Majestic is known for its roaches. The cabins at Elderwood are pretty nice, though.
That sounds perfect.
I'm Dr. Emil Hartman. I'd like to invite you to stay at Cauldron Lake Lodge.
Did you talk to my wife?
I had the pleasure of discussing your situation with her on several occasions.
Did you set something up with her?
I invited her here. My clinic is a place where...
Oh!
Hey!
Oh my!
Take it easy.
Hey, nobody move! Get your hands off of my client!
Who are you?
I'm Barry Wheeler, his agent. If you have business with Mr. Wake, you talk to me. You yokels won't know what hit you once I sick my lawyers on your asses.
No harm done, Sarah. I'm all right. I don't want to press charges. Mr. Wake, my offer still stands.
Get me out of here.
What the hell was that about, Al? We don't need a replay of that thing with the paparazzi. I thought they were gonna lock you up.
I had to talk to someone.
I told Barry everything. He thought I was certifiable, but when he heard about the manuscript, I had him. The fact that I'd written something, even if I couldn't remember it, was enough for him. He smelled money, and he believed that Alice had been kidnapped. Anything beyond that was another story. I had a midnight appointment with the kidnapper in a place called Lover's Peak, somewhere in Elderwood National Park. The plan was to rent a cabin.
I don't like it, Al. I don't like any of it. It's not good. In fact, it's the absolute opposite of good.
Mr. Wake! Barry, you found him.
Hi, Rose.
Oh, wow. I was just thinking about you, too.
Great.
I was just bringing Rusty some coffee. He's on the balcony, looking after Max. Poor thing. I really need to go. Great to see you again, Mr. Wake. Later!
Who's Max?
What an airhead.
Jeez, Mr. Takes a Swing at Everybody. This is not her fault. She's a very nice girl and, more importantly, a fan. She even has a fan site dedicated to you.
Oh boy. I guess we're gonna find out about Rusty in just a moment, but... Talk to the Charlie the Colombian Mammoth. Well, do they mean Colombian as in... I don't know which Colombia they're referring to there, because there's Colombia with a U and Colombia with an O, which are etymologically the same, but...
You shot a guy and his body just disappeared? When was the last time you slept? Are you high? Have you been drinking?
No! Look, Barry, I'm missing a week! And someone's got Alice!
Do you understand what it sounds like when you say stuff like that? Don't get me wrong, it's a good story, could be a bestseller. But when you start confusing fiction with reality, you're buying yourself a ticket to the funny farm!
Wait here.
Wait here, I'm gonna grab something from the kitchen real quick. Then we can resume that conversation. Okay, well, I'm here again. Well, I guess we're not going to resume this conversation. So I assume now that it's,
Hey, Rusty, right? You rent cabins.
It ran its course.
Shake your hand, but mine are kind of full here. Actually, I'm sorry about this. Would you mind grabbing the registration form from the desk? It's just across from Bucktooth Charlie.
Okay, sure.
What is the deal with the doggo here?
Max here got his foot caught in a trap. They're illegal to use here. Hell, you're not supposed to hunt within the park at all. But that doesn't stop some lowlifes. Well, at least Max is gonna be okay. He got lucky.
That seems like he got lucky. As far as which part of him got caught in that.
Just yet. The form's on the desk across from the mammoth skeleton.
I don't even think it has to be a bear trap, even with bad things happening with garage doors.
And meet a kidnapper? Those situations always end up in disaster. You gotta talk to the cops.
She's my wife, and it's my call. Can we talk about this later?
No. This whole thing is... Listen, you hit your head. I mean, geez, Al, come on. You gotta understand how crazy all this sounds. If you're trying to pull a joke on me, freak me out, it's working. Ha ha, let's have a laugh on Barry. Well, you had me going there real funny, Al. You can quit it now.
Alright, well. I'm just kind of interested to see why kidnappers would be involved in this at all, to be frank with you. I feel like that's the piece of the story that I want to have laid out in front of me at this point.
I think that's the form you wanted.
Here, Max, you can look at this.
Okay, you're all set, Blake. Glad to have you staying here.
Max, can you tell me how to get to Lover's Peak?
Oh, sure. It's at the end of the nature trail. Just follow the paths, so you'll get to it eventually. It's an easy walk. Nice spot, too.
The end of the trail. Right. So...
If you have any trouble finding it, just keep your eyes on the radio mast. It's right below that.
Okay, well, I can barely see the radio mast from here, but I suppose it is over there. Keep your eyes on the radio mast, and apparently it's right below from that.
You're asking me to believe that you shot a dude who went, poof, into thin air... A guy who was bulletproof until you pointed a flashlight at him. You hear that from people who end up spending time in padded rooms, strapped to their beds, wearing white shirts with too long tangled up sleeves, and eating a healthy diet of pills. Al, you make cruel jokes about people who believe that kind of stuff. You're the skeptic. You gave me an hour-long lecture on homeopathy last month. What was it? If there's no proof, it's pure bullshit. Period.
Guess the laugh's on me then.
Al, come on! I mean, okay. Okay, maybe something weird happened to you, okay?
Well, thanks for the heartfelt vote of confidence.
All I'm saying is you gotta throw me a bone here, bestseller. What would you think if it was me? There's no way you should be going out at midnight with a gun.
No one asked you to come here, Barry. Either work with me on this or go straight back to New York. Your choice.
Okay. Okay, we read about walk to the charger, I suppose. Scared of oh, Jesus Christ. Camera angle even is making me... go... bleh. Specimen estimated to be 14,000 years old, was recovered from the Labrea Tar Pit in 1981. Resonated to the Elder Wood National Park in 1998 when the Columbian Mammoth became Washington's state fossil. Named Bucktooth Charlie, it has since become the park's official mascot. Okay. Well, let's go. I guess we just do everything to do with the car and just while away the rest of the day automatically now.
We should go to the sheriff or call the FBI.
Damn it, Barry, they'll kill her! This is not a goddamn debate, Barry. I'm going to Lover's Peak. He said to come alone.
Okay then. I understand. You're my best friend and I'm worried that you're not right in the head. Tell me what to do to help and I'll do it.
You stay here, and if I'm not back by morning, call the cavalry.
Nice one, that is pretty. Jeez.
Oh, are dangerous. Everybody hates a tourist, or it'll be deliverance all over again.
Well, I don't know what that is, but thanks, Barry. I don't know which particular trope they are referring to there. Well, I mean, that's actually the opposite of what I mean. I know what the trope is. I just don't know the specifics. Got some more batteries, because I guess we ended up losing our extra batteries that we had. And we also don't have a gun right now. We can turn the lights off. I guess I'm going to leave them on. Guess Barry can decide if he wants them on or off once we're gone. We just get out of here. Out through here, apparently. What about these lights? Are they separate? Nope. Can't turn on any more lights, would appear to be the case. Okay, here we go. Off we go to Lover's Peak. If I can get to Lover's Peak and get like a chapter break there, that'll probably be as far as I can play. For the time being. I mean, I'll try to soldier on, but I don't think I've had any really bad consequences from experiences with nausea like this in the recent past, but I definitely have had them before, so don't matter weighing it too much. I mean, there was this one time where I was visiting relatives in Nicaragua a couple years ago. Actually, more like a year and a half ago at this point, I would say. Not quite a couple years ago, but anyway, there was a sandwich that I had gotten on the plane to get over there. I had kept, and that cat been just kind of sitting out in the heat for a couple days, so I ate that and then I got into a long car ride to go to a nearby population, so I can kind of imagine how that went. I don't want this to go that way, but I guess we're not supposed to go this way. I often do forget that I technically do have like a little, like a radar thing that I can use to tell me where to go here. Okay. I guess I lost my shoot gun and I lost all my flare gun ammo and I guess all that got reset. Wonder if that's gonna happen like between every chapter or episode or what have you, whatever those divisions are called.
I knew I should have gone to the cops. This wasn't the smartest thing I'd ever done, but I was still angry with Barry for trying to talk me out of it. These people had called me right in the sheriff's station. The cops wouldn't scare them. And they had Alice.
Okay, I'll do a little moment. Let's... God, every single time that I like stop for a moment or like even blink. Like it gets worse.
Barry had never gotten along with Alice, but he knew Alan loved her with an almost frightening intensity. And now something had happened to Alice. And here was Al armed with a gun and saying things people got put in padded cells for. It was as if his friend had experienced a massive psychotic episode and was totally disconnected from reality.
Well, at least he conceded to that it was probably a good idea to call the police if, you know, Alan wasn't back after the meeting. It's not very clear how much he would potentially be able to do to protect him and Alice after that point, though. But... oh jeez, yeah, I might have to cut this short before too long, actually, if it gets much worse. Or maybe take a break. I feel like it would be a bit of a moot point to take a break at this point, though. Might be a good idea. I get the feeling that there was another inspiration joke that I was gonna make before I even got down here, but I completely blanked on what it was. Oh yeah, it was, now I remember what it was. I was gonna say they were invincible until you shone light on them. Now I see where in the other world ends with you got its inspiration. Let's see what's here. Switch the lights, we turn on the radio, let's take this opportunity for me to take a break, I guess.
Our very own Dr. Nelson has just parked his rear end in the studio. Doc, what's your Deerfest plan like?
My plan? You make it sound a lot more organized than I ever seem to manage. No plan, really, just taking the atmosphere. I'm getting a little too rickety to do much more than that, you know.
Tell me about it. No sack race for us older gentlemen, huh?
Yes, exactly, Pat. But I'm going to check out the parade, of course. And I'll be one of the pie contest judges, too.
Well, that takes a different kind of constitution.
Oh, yeah. It's my kind of exercise.
Now, Doc, seriously, you're in pretty good shape, though. You're the outdoors type. I know for a fact you're an avid fisherman.
That's right. Matter of fact, just caught a heck of a largemouth bass early this morning.
But you're not taking part in the fishing contest?
No, not this year. See, Pat, I'm just not that competitive anymore. Now I just like to take my time and enjoy the peace of it. It's no fun if I need to worry about what I'm catching, you know?
Well, considering your track record, the participants are probably pretty happy you feel that.
Well, Pat, that's kind of you to say.
Oh, that cut off. Okay, let's see. Is there anything in the closet here? Revolver ammo. Well, so definitely nowhere near, like, the actual cap for revolver ammo, it would seem. Oh, and there's the dude right outside. Maybe I will have to deal with him right soon. I'm gonna try that for a moment. It just seems like a little... moment to rest my eyes. All that radio thing was going on, and that does seem to have helped, but I continue to feel. Well, I guess I'll do that. I'll try to get into a checkpoint, which might be about to happen here, given that there's a light up ahead. Or not. And then I'll probably take another break. Well, the only quick break that I've technically would have taken at this point. And look at all those physics. These chairs also have physics? They do. Does this waste bin have physics? It does. Too bad you can't use the swing or the... Well, I guess the swing is the only thing there is. It's like a park game kind of thing. Like in Resident Evil 6 where you can have like... a fucking Chris Redfield drive the mechanical children's games in a little park section. Well, apparently the light went away, so I guess it was not to be a checkpoint after all. That's very unfortunate. Elderwood Nature Trail, Moonshine Cave, and Lover's Peak. What's in here? Boy. Another one of these. Oh, we're gonna be here for a while. Crime and punishment. If it's anything like the last one. The cancer and cure of civilization. But some crimes are impossible to punish. Especially in Night Springs.
Tonight's episode. The Man in the Mirror.
He's inside, Agent. He's a weird one.
So, you're confessing to killing that guy, huh? Why?
And it coming?
Yeah, but why would you do that? I mean, you're a nice guy. Normal. Took a kid to a soccer game. So how come at the game, you pick a guy and, quoting from the arresting officer's report here, assault the victim's head area repeatedly with the weapon of choice being a pair of bare fists? Wow, that sentence really flows, huh? Maybe you're not the literary type. Okay, so you mess him up. But why? Who was that guy? We couldn't ID him. Why would a guy like you do him like that?
I didn't like his face.
Well, you must have hated it, because you really went to town there. I mean, there's no way to tell what he looked like. No ID on him either.
That must be difficult.
But then we ran the fingerprints. Got a match. Your prints. Identical.
Huh, how about that?
Your son said you were wearing a white shirt when you took him to the game. The white shirt is on the dead guy.
It's plenty red now.
You won't get away with this.
Do you really think that's in any way relevant to me? I had plenty of time to talk to my boy before the cops arrived, you know? He won't stop screaming, am I right? You think he's ever gonna be okay? I left my mark. Believe me.
You bastard.
What? You gonna shoot me? What's the point? I'm going to prison. You got me.
I don't understand any of this.
And you never will. Don't worry. Maybe you'll see me again, Agent. Maybe in the mirror.
No closing narration? So what, he was trying to traumatize his own kid? Is that what he was implying at the end? Don't understand the logic behind any of that. Or is he saying that the cop that was interrogating him was somehow also the same as him somehow? Which I don't think makes any degree of sense either, but... use the phone right now. How convenient that a phone would be available at a trail area after permission has stopped being find a phone. Well, I guess I mean we did find a phone before. We'd find a phone before, like in the middle of the previous episode, whole hiking trail section, but the difference there being that we didn't do what? Well, we did call out from it, but we got immediately interrupted by the evil shadow guys doing something. Chopping the lights. Falling rock so down, I'm pretty sure we just got a checkpoint, so now would probably be a good time for me to take a break. But before I do that, I guess I'll check out these couple of pages that I've just acquired. Rose and Rusty and Rusty Dying.
The air in the visitor center was heavy with an awful smell, as if some rotten drowned thing had crawled up from its grave. Rusty kept coughing blood. My eyes were drawn to the twisted shape of his broken leg. The attack had been vicious. Max whined in his cage. Rusty's eyes were wild with fear and terror. He gasped. Mr. Wake, it happened just the way it was on that page.
On that page. Couldn't have been the one that, couldn't have been the one that's directly before that, surely, because that's the one about Barry.
Rose knew that Rusty was in love with her, and she liked him too. She liked him a lot. He taught her to dance, and life had certainly taught her the value of a man who was gentle. He treated her well, made her smile,
made her feel good. But Rusty wasn't the prince of her dreams, and that tended to underline the unbearable truth. She was no closer to that Hollywood magic than he was.
Did she really want that Hollywood magic that clearly, or that badly? Well, I think we're gonna keep walking down the trail, but we're gonna do it now in just a few more minutes. Right now, I think I do still intend to at least get to the end of this episode. I think that's actually the word that's used to mark the divisions in this game before I call things. But I do need to take a quick break to maybe settle a couple of things in my brain right now. So I'll be doing that and be back in just a few moments. And by moments, I mean minutes. Let's see what the playlist is gonna prop up. I guess I'm gonna restart this track. In just a moment. Yeah, that'll do. All of these things will do. So I'll be back in a few. Please hang tight.
Things just ain't the same anymore in this town.
Oh, things have not been the same for a long time, I think, but... Well, I hope I'm a little bit... in a better state now, at least. At least in a good enough state where I can get to the end of this... part of the whole thing. Okay, there it goes. Didn't have to reset it after all, but I did it anyway. The window, the process hook fee. So there we go. Let's see if I can at least. Oh, wait. Just grabbed into the wrong top of the window there. Just put it into place, make sure that everything is perfectly alright, and I guess fade this out manually, because this isn't like Music B where it's like an automatic fade out whenever you pause something. And there we go. Okay, let's see if I can get to the end of the episode, like I said, at least. Hopefully we're gonna be good in that regard. Oh shit. Apparently I paused just in time. And... Well, I can moonwalk a little bit in order to get over there. I guess we're going to help Rusty first, though. And trying to complete whatever our task is gonna turn out to be. I think that I'm gonna have to keep doing this if I come back to this game, or when I come back to this game later in the week, though. Yeah, there will be somebody coming, don't you worry about that. Just gonna have to grab me this coffee thermos first. Or I could try to go past this gate. That side actually had some writing on it that might be useful. Oh goodness, oh shit. I did notice some of these hanging like live wires before, but I think I had actually gotten damaged by any of them until now. I mean, I do want to get to see what's in here, but... having a lot of luck with all the shamanic group page right there. Just kind of difficult to tell apart from, I guess, the other stones that are on the ledge surface.
The ranger's office was locked. I'd need a key to get in.
Maybe the key will be hidden in this page somewhere.
The visitor center was sturdy, but the impact turned the front of the building into splinters. Rusty was thrown across the lobby like a rag doll and hit the far wall hard. It didn't hurt until he tried to move and saw his leg bend the wrong way. Felt the broken rib stabbing him on the inside. Rusty howled in pain and fear, suddenly afraid to die alone.
Well, he wouldn't die alone if he had Max with him, surely.
I'm back here. Hey, please help me.
Also, a big old chunk of blood on the wall there. I can't tell what direction that is, Rusty. I'm sorry, I'm gonna have to check all the doors before I get over there. Oh, there he is. He's literally in line of sight.
Mr. Wake? Oh, hell. It happened. Just the way it was on that page. I found. Came true. It knew. So dark. It'll come back for me. You must. The lights. In the office. I have the key.
Okay, Rusty. Hang on. I'll be right back.
Whatever did this couldn't be far. Rusty had found a page from the manuscript. It would help me understand what had happened.
Okay, so I guess now the manuscript thing is actually part of our objective. I guess we're not getting the lights on by loitering in the kitchen again.
The only way to make sure that Rusty was safe was to get the power running and the lights back on.
I don't know what those bird calls are, but I get the feeling that those bird calls, speaking of Dark Souls. Well, speaking of Dark Souls, not recently, but I'm pretty sure that I mentioned that recently as part of the whole Everything is Born of Darkness and Return to Darkness plot point thing. Pretty sure that those bird calls that I'm hearing from time to time are the same kind of sound as the mushroom kids make when you kill them in Dark Souls. My batteries now. My revolver ammo now. Well, here's the breaker, which apparently someone else who wanted to do a Jack Nicholson cosplay had done that. And now the darkness is just thrashing around over there. Okay, we did find a manuscript page over here, didn't we? Hold on. Clearly, if this manuscript page is the one that he was talking about, then surely it must help us figure out what to do here.
The last instant, I changed direction and threw myself down. The axe splintered the trunk of a tree. I stumbled into the pool of bright light. My lungs burned. I was too exhausted to move. I tensed as I waited for the killing blow, but it never came. I raised my head. I moved in the darkness beyond. For the moment, bathed in the cold light, I was safe.
Cold lights. I mean, by the cold lights, surely you don't mean something like blue lights, since we already know.
Was covered with oily patches. Wait, what? That looked like liquid darkness.
Oh. So it was. I guess we can disintegrate that darkness if I am so inclined, but I guess it would also end up. Might as well do a little bit of that. I am so inclined, I can patiently stand here and let it disintegrate. Because apparently if I don't, it will. It will cause me to waste away myself. Okay, that time I missed. What about this little patch of darkness? Doesn't really seem to be in the way, but might as well be thorough here, you know. It will cover at least the angles nearing the exit. So was one of those people the guy? That's not a mammoth-sized hole. You can literally see a mammoth right behind you, and I don't think a mammoth could walk through that hole. I'm just being dramatic for the sake of trying to flower up your prose. God damn it, I already... Well, it's literally on screen, I just noticed. I was gonna say you already forgot the guy's name. Alright, I guess Trusty has become our boss fight for this part. Oh no. Oh shit. Oh shit. Alright, I guess I'll use a battery. And shoot Rusty to death, even though he was asking for my help just a little while ago. At least I can restock right now, as far as the revolver ammo. And also, I'll end up getting ambushed by even more of these fuckers. Don't worry, I can be patient and use the other method to wait for that guy to become vulnerable. Okay. But yeah, I mean, judging by how many resources I've been able to find so far in these types of gameplay sections, I guess I probably wouldn't be surprised if be surprised by anything right now, but wouldn't be surprised if the game does expect you to like use up all of the resources that you get in each chapter before you get to the end of that chapter. What's up?
What the hell was that? I saw from the window. I saw something.
Forget about it, Barry. It's just me going crazy.
Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez. You're not crazy. I wish you were crazy, but you're not crazy. Ow, be careful.
Stay in the cabin. Don't open the door for anyone. I mean it.
Well, maybe he would have said keep the lights off, but you know, to not let people know that you're there, but I guess that would be counterproductive to the stay safe part. Guess we're still going to do this kidnapper meetup though, even though we've got more dark nonsense to deal with on the way. And more pages. Not this six pack of beer though. I guess that's a little too worse for wear. It's taking a bit of a beating. Well, we're gonna get the lover speak soon, after another checkpoint, I guess, which will only take us an opportunity to look at this.
Rusty thought about Rose. He was older than she was. Rose was barely out of her teens, but she made him feel young and forget what a train wreck his long dead marriage had been. He still wore the ring. He'd been waiting for her to tell him to take it off. Now she never would.
Well, maybe she might do that to her, to his dead body, or at least a symbolic address to his immortal soul or something like that. She could still do that. She felt like it. It's not an impossibility as long as she's still around. Designated hiking trail, or you could completely ignore that warning and go searching for thermos or stuff like that. But apparently not too a very fruitful thing to not what feed wildlife. $100 penalty. That doesn't seem like a lot considering.
Lover's Peak was at the far end of the nature trail.
What if I went this way instead? Moonshine Cave. I mean, the door looks like it's open. Now I gotta find a stash of moonshine in here. Site of frequent bootlegger activity throughout the Prohibition. It was mostly used for temporary storage of alcohol smuggled from Canada, but at times alcohol was also distilled on premises. Okay, so I guess that's something that I haven't necessarily understood about the Prohibition, because I think this is not the only game that I've seen, or just not the only piece of media in general that I've seen that refers to, like, stuff being smuggled from Canada. So am I to understand that? I haven't really looked into it at all. I could easily do that, but yes, I implicitly assume that Canada was not actually affected by the Prohibition like the United States was. Finders Keepers. I keep getting these achievements, but I'm not sure exactly what for. I mean, I'm guessing that this one was for finding more of these hidden stashes. I have a shootgun now, but I think I'm gonna hold off on that. On using that unless I get another boss encounter or something like that. Even then, if I get, like, infinite revolver ammo for something to that effect, I probably will seek to take advantage of that. Why don't you look at that? The light broke. How inconvenient. Oh, and here comes some hunty fellas to take advantage of that. Oh, and here comes a guy that just was somehow able to sneak up behind me. Apparently these guys can- oh Jesus Christ. I can't tell what the fuck is going on with the camera right now. That I feel doesn't really help my very frequent bursts of motion sickness in this either. Sounds like it's probably working, but I guess we're not concerned with finding a phone anymore, at least not as badly as we were before now. Hopefully it doesn't take too long to get through the rest of this. This pace, at the pace that it's making me feel sick, even now. Even if I did get a little bit of a fresh breath in meanwhile, it's not quite stopping. What do we got?
Lee and Bright Falls seemed to know where Al was, but Rose, the waitress at the diner, had seen him. From what Barry could tell, Al pretty much fell off the face of the earth when he left the diner. Rose was just the kind of fan that Al hated, but she really tried to help. She was smart, too. Knew a lot about what was going on in the town. Knew a lot about Al. Even knew who Barry was. Barry liked her. That was no big surprise. When it came to women, Barry and Al rarely saw eye to eye.
But also, Alan just explicitly admits to hating her. At least on this, or by way of this manuscript, which we assume to have somehow come from him, or at least another quantum version of him, or something like that. I guess that's probably, it's probably gonna turn out to be some kind of significance in that regard, as far as that, the first of those Twilight Zone parodies that we saw. I get a feeling that we're being stalked right now, but still don't feel like stopping. I also have no idea where I'm going, just in general, but I guess I'm gonna try to get back into a trail. There really is a lot of, like, fluff areas that you can go to that don't really seem to yield anything. What do we got? Shootgun again and shootgun ammo. Can't remember if we saw a checkpoint reach just here, but yeah. Honestly, I think I'm gonna restart checkpoint right now, literally just to check to see if we've gotten this, because I feel like probably not helped by that encounter just a little bit ago, but I think I'm gonna have to actually call it here. I really don't think that it'll go that way if I keep going at the state that I'm in right now, so I think it's gonna be a better idea to ration this out at this point. I'll move away from that and see if I can try to make myself feel better a little bit by resting up, maybe. Maybe just try to figure out what exactly and clear up exactly what was has got me feeling this week. So I don't think it's just the game, but anyway. Yeah, probably gonna be a better idea to do that right now. Taking license and saying that, and I'm gonna play this, I guess, a little bit more. Go ahead and restart that for a moment so I can go to this screen and actually play things out right now, but yeah. Like I have said, I will continue to try and play this game tomorrow and for the remainder of the week. I do want to try to see if I can beat it this week, but hopefully I don't keep on getting complications, you know, like that. I guess I'll try to be mindful of that in the future. As much as being mindful of that is going to make a difference in how that affects me, but I guess we'll see. I mean, I want to be optimistic about this. Since I do want to beat this game, which I got the achievements, Finders Keepers, under a thin layer of skin, and two for the price of one for the shotgun one. Apparently that shotgun thing is the least common of the achievements that I've gotten, so I also got the Rose card, the card for that doctor guy whose name I already forgot, even though it's right here. Hartman? I think it's Hartman. And I also still have two copies of the Barry cards. I'm guessing that since this thing has 8 cards, that's as many as I... No, wait. Oh yeah, 8 cards. That's as many as I'm gonna get. Without having to, like, do the trading thing for them. But yeah. I think that we're just gonna call it here and hopefully be able to return to this without greater issue tomorrow. So you'll take it easy, I think, everybody, for coming, like always. Thanks for chatting, always great whenever people chat, and I will see you later.